The tattoos on my finger, that was like for me to mark the moment that I discovered that I got accepted to Stanford. On March 1st, it was so weird to see that congratulations. I had to read like thousands of times and check the name, like, it's Luciana, that's the right Luciana. That was a moment that changed my life forever, so I had to mark on me. Action. My name is Luciana Frazão. I'm a second year master's student in mechanical engineering here at Stanford University. And I'm a student worker here at the Office of Religious and Spiritual Life. And I'm one of the Meeting the Moment fellows. I'm the youngest daughter of a single mom, and coming from a low-income family in a country like Brazil is not easy because you have to work twice, three times harder to show that you're worth it. When I read my acceptance letter, seeing that I didn't get the scholarship was like, oh, okay, so I'm not going to Stanford. But come on, I got accepted to Stanford. Like, I have to go to Stanford. So my mom and I started a crazy journey to try to get the money. I think it's like because I have so many amazing people, you know, like around me, and he's super smart, but no one here gonna work more than me. And when I put that inside my, you know, like my mind, crazy things started to happen. We have a TV show in Brazil, like the Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. In my mind, that was the solution, you know, that was waiting to make it able for me to be here. I needed 500,000 reais. And I end up with 50,000, like only 10% of what I needed. After losing, I left the studios and I gave up. It's not to be, you know, like I literally done everything. I was defeated. My mom started to get nuts about it because I was working so hard towards it, and on her mind, made no sense that I would not achieve. But a week later, problem was solved. This one, Coulomb's Law. Hello, engineers. I decided to tattoo Coulomb's Law because of Coulomb's birthday, June 14th. That's the day that I met the person that changed my life. Carlos Brito, when I met him, I had no idea who he were. When I started to read and know more about him, he's a person that makes me super proud of being Brazilian and of how I came to Stanford. My mom, she just told me, oh, I have an event from the work. My boss really wanted me to go, so we went to this conference. And during the cocktail party, my mom, you know, like she was walking around and I was just like sitting on a table waiting for her. I hear her voice. Like, oh, that's my daughter. And I look up, this guy suddenly asked me, like, did you answer yes on your acceptance letter to Stanford? And I was like, yes, like, who are you? And then he just said, you're going to Stanford, I'm paying for it. I don't know, like a few seconds of trying to understand what was happening. And after that was like minutes of crying. Because, come on, like that was the moment that I never expected to happen to me, especially because I was feeling defeated. And on that moment, he told me his story. He's the CEO of AB InBev, one of the biggest companies in the world. He got accepted to Stanford during the 80s to the business school, and his family had no money to afford for it either. And a guy in Brazil helped him. And one of the things this guy asked back was for him to help someone the same way he would be helped. And in fact, that was the thing that he asked me, like the moment he told me he would make my dream come true, he gave me this vision of, the only thing I ask you back is for you to help someone when you have the chance to do so. And I'm glad that now I am able to do so. It was a little bit of luck perhaps, yes, but the engineer side of me don't believe much in coincidence. Each one of us gave the most they could give to make it happen. So, yeah, I prefer to think like as a teamwork than just being at the right place at the right time.